I teach English in this monastery school. I have been teaching here for 2 years now. But I was teacher in the public school there, and I was the headmaster there. I've been working there for 27 years. And this is our system after working for 25 years that we have to give the job to young ones, the other ones with the job. So I'm retired from this other school, and I joined in this school here. So I've been living in Pokhara since 1965. I left Tibet in 1959. At the time I was 10 years old, and I came with my parents and my brother and sister. It was very hard to come over the Himalayas. It was a hard time. The Chinese were chasing us. They have guns. They come. We have to come at night. In the daytime, we had to hide in the trees, jungles, one of the forest. And at night, we have to move towards the border to Nepal. So I came to Nepal in April. So it was almost one month to cross the border. After coming to Kathmandu, well, I stayed with an American family in Kathmandu for 5 years. So I was I was adopted by this family. So I lived with them for 5 years, and then they taught me English. And then I started having a job here. So now I'm fine. I have I'm married here. I have I have 4 children.
Yeah.
They go to school still. So the camp here is very peaceful. It's good. The land is provided by the government of Nepal. It's good. Yeah. We're staying here friendly with the local people. It's no problem. But what the thing that we need is why we want to move to go back to Tibet if the Chinese could change their mind. Mm-hmm. So this is my aim today.
This is about the old Tibetan to wake up for freedoms, about freedom.
And to now we have to look for how we can get our country
back from China.
Back from China.
Why are we so intrigued with the Tibetans and their culture? What is it about these people that calls to our hearts and makes us want to support their struggle? When the Dalai Lama was awarded the Nobel Peace Prize in 1989, the committee emphasized that in his struggle for the liberation of Tibet, the Dalai Lama consistently has opposed the use of violence. He has instead advocated peaceful solutions based upon tolerance and mutual respect in order to preserve the historical and cultural heritage of the Tibetan people. The question is, what is the next step?
We are now, I think, the second generation, and we have now the youngsters who are third generation, second generation. They still have the hope of returning back to a free Tibet. One summer, one day. But this hope is, I think this hope will remain there with every one of the Tibetans that to see their country freed from this forceful occupation by Chinese.
Tibetans, today Tibetans are settled everywhere. Everywhere, all over the world. But they won't, you know, lose their identity. And their men, you know, is, you know, inspiration will still be His Holiness Dalai Lama, and it will remain forever for every Tibetan.
Okay, when we were small, we have been hearing from our parents that we would be going back to Tibet very soon. And then after my college, we have been still here and have been hearing. And then when I started to stand on my own feet, we try our best to get ourselves get involved in doing some kind of activities, how to go back to Tibet and spread awareness in the local people and outside how Tibet was and how it is now, the fact. And in this way, we hope that the truth prevails someday. Mm-hmm. So that's our only hope, and we're still hoping.